Hi everybody, welcome to the Java example section. In this section, I'm going to set up a system to evaluate the vehicle insurance premium. The premium would depend on the vehicle types. Suppose I have four types of vehicles: car, truck, bus, and motorcycle. And for the motorcycle, I would have three types of motorcycles: low power, medium power, and high power. To evaluate the correct amount of the premium, I would use nested switch case approach. Okay, let's see how we can implement this idea. I would ask for the user input first, so I would need the scanner class to be imported. And then after I imported the scanner class, I can ask for the user input. I can also ask for the more precise type by listing my required types. And then I can do the user input by creating a scanner object. So the variable called scan is an object reference variable that stores the reference to a scanner object. Here, system.in means that I'm going to obtain the value from the keyboard. Okay, the value obtained from the scanner object will be stored in a variable called type. And the variable called type here would store the reference to the string obtained from the system.in input approach. I have a variable called premium to store the amount evaluated later. Now I use the switch command. If the user input is CAR car, the premium is $200, and then I break. It means that I will leave the switch conditional statement. I do the same thing for the truck. And the same thing for bus. How about motorcycle? For motorcycles, we have three types. We have to depend on the type of the motorcycle to evaluate the premium. I would ask for the user input again to let me know the type of the motorcycle. one for low power, two for medium power, and three for high power. So I simply ask for a number from the user. For simplicity, I can still use the scanner object whose reference is called scan. So when I use next line, I would accept a string from the user input. But since I want to manipulate the value obtained from user as integers, I can do something like this. Okay, this part is going to interpret the string values 1, 2, or 3 to become integers. So the motorcycle int variable will be storing the numerical value converted from the string values obtained by the scanner object whose reference is called scan. Here we have to use capital I because this integer refers to the back class called integer class whose values will be represented by integer objects. Now I can treat the value motorcycle int as integers. If it is low power, the premium is $300. I can do similar things for the medium power and high power motorcycles. I can also add a default case. If the motorcycle type input by the user is not 1, 2, or 3, I would print out the statement here. A non-motorcycle type. Okay, this break statement is going to be followed by the case motorcycle statement here. So this part is a break statement. Okay. And if any of these vehicle type input fails, I will do something like this. I will simply say that you have given me an unknown vehicle type. So that means you don't give me car, truck, bus, or motorcycle at the beginning. After I've used the scanner object whose reference variable is called scan, I close the scanner object. okay, finally I can print out the premium according to this nested switch case method. So this is the nested part. Okay, so if the motorcycle case is not chosen, we can have either car, truck, bus, or simply go to the default section by saying that you have input an unknown vehicle type. So let me try to run it. Oh, error. Where is it? Oh, I have to use capital C. Suppose I input car. The premium is $200 according to the case shown here. Let me run it. If I enter motorcycle, I would need to input the type of the motorcycle. Suppose it is 3, so the amount will be $500 according to the nested switch case component here. Let me run it again. If I say something else rather than these four types, for example, minibus, I would get a unknown vehicle type because this type is not included in the switch case conditional statement. The premium is 0 because I will simply print out the value initialized at the very beginning. So if there is a kind of mismatch with the cases in the nested switch case approach, I will simply print out the initialized value 0 as the answer for this printing statement. My code is intuitive and straightforward, but it may not be the best or the most efficient approach. If you can think about any idea to improve the code, feel free to do so on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.